at the end where we get to talk about each other's journeys, things like that. Very hyped for this. So I'm curious how many of you have come across the Stellar Gateway or the Galactic Internet before this, because before I wanted to make this class, I actually first kept hearing about, my guys kept talking about this Galactic Internet, and I was like, this is so cool, right? And I started doing it for a few months, and then that's when I was like, you know what, I want to teach the family about this, and I want to do this together. So I was kind of getting a meditation together, and like I was working with the GFL to create a meditation, and then I was like, all right, now we're gonna make something about this. Okay, so first, let's start out. I want to say first, shout out to the crew. I'm seeing all the homies up in here. What's good? And now let's talk about what the Galactic Internet is first. Now, with this one, you could connect with the Galactic Internet, or you could connect with your higher self. And this is going to help you a lot. And I have a bunch of images that we're going to go through, okay? Because we're also going to talk about a little bit about 5D, all right? If you guys want to, we could dive into that and stepping into 5D more, which is a huge part of this meditation as well. Okay, so I'm going to pull up some of these pictures. I'm gonna show y'all what is up. Hey, what's up, Corinne? Okay, so you guys have seen this before, and this is one of my favorites. And this is what I actually wanted to make a video about. I remember people were saying, can you make a meditation about this? So I thought, you know what, let's just do it in the Discord together. And we'll do it in 10 minutes. I just wanna go over some things a bit first. So what is the Galactic Internet? What is the Stellar Gateway? Now, this is the consciousness of the entire galaxy. So you could feel literally the collective consciousness of the galaxy within just when you do a Galactic Internet meditation. Now, you could connect with the Galactic Internet all day, every day, right? You could do it whenever you like. And I've noticed when you do it in meditations, I feel like when you connect with the galaxy and you do it in a meditation, you're going to feel it deep. But when you do it just on the regular day and you're kind of just always connected, you're going to feel the busyness of the galaxy, which is what I find it funny, because you're going to feel all the beings in the galaxy. You're going to feel the busyness and like the love being exchanged. And you're going to feel the fighting going on in certain areas. 80% of the galaxy is positive now, so you don't got to worry too much about that. But you will feel the busyness and the hustle and bustle and the community, which is amazing. Okay. So first, actually, let's talk about how y'all been feeling energetically lately. How many of you have been feeling a little more open or a little more closed off? And I'm talking energetic, how you've just been feeling in general. Oh, thank you for this, Andy. Oh, I like this. This is talking about the chakras. Ooh, and it's going even beyond. You already know we got so much beyond the body. So I really like this. Feeling open and on fire. Yes, ma'am. Feeling sleepy, closed off. That's all right. I've been feeling both. It's weird. Me too. So I actually been feeling a lot more open as well, but also a little more irritable. I know for some of y'all that were with me, we went on the astral trip last night. A bunch of y'all was feeling tired after you want to take the day. I was kind of feeling irritable because I was kind of annoyed with, for those who know, you know what was happening. I was like kind of annoyed. And then I was like, all right, and I had to kind of like, I took the rest of the morning to just chill a minute. And then I did have my assignments later, so I still had to do stuff. But I've been feeling both, like open and closed, and also kind of like a kind of antsy. I'm like, I don't know what to do. Like today, I had some things I had to do, but other things I was like, I have some time. I could make a video now, where I could start writing more of my book now. Or I could go in and start chatting with some of the crew, but I didn't feel like doing anything. I was like, how come I don't feel like doing much? And so I end up just, when I notice I'm like that, I take the day to meditate and journal and do, I call it a catch-up day. That's where I do like laundry and some more meditations, journaling, things like that. Yeah, that's what I love to do when I get an antsy day, kind of like that. That was kind of me today. Also today, I felt really hard in my head. Did one massage to my client and I did it really hard. Oh, you mean like you could, like your head felt like it was pulsing? Like it felt like pressure on your head? How you doing, Robbie? I missed you too, bro. We're going to catch up soon, okay? That's wild. You know, I've been feeling that, I feel that pressure when my third eye is expanding. And it feels like, kind of feels like someone's squeezing your head a little bit, but you could feel it right, Nessa. Right, Nessa. And like I started flicking y'all off. You can feel it like right in the center of your head. That's what I find really I actually like that feeling. I know y'all like that feeling too, but it's kind of, especially when it's a lot, you're just like, oh, it just feels like it's squeezing. Yes. Ooh. Ari said, I got recently pulsing on my third eye and on the crown, like really. Ooh, and especially with where you're at right now, Ari. Yeah, you get some expansion. So no coincidence, right? I really love the feeling of the third, especially when you do a third eye meditation, bro. You feel the pulsing. You know what? We could do one right now, okay? Because what we're about to do right now, this meditation, you're going to feel your third eye guaning, bro. You're going to feel it guaning. Okay. First, though, let me just go over some of these questions, then we're going to go into it. I just want to say quickly that, remember, the Stellar Gateway, the gateway gives you access to the entire galaxy. So from there, you could start remote viewing. You could start, it's basically like astral traveling, but while you're in your body, you could just view what's going on. You could feel what's going on. And you have access to the Akashic. You have access to literally anything in the galaxy. You're going to feel all the being. The Soul Star, if you want to do one instead of the Stellar Gateway, you're doing the Soul Star. That one's cool too. You're going to feel your higher self more. You're going to feel it stronger. It feels like it's right there with you. Same thing with the Stellar Gateway. You feel like the galaxy is right there with you. You may notice when you connect to the Stellar Gateway or your Soul Star, it feels like when you look up that you could like see them. That's the only way to explain it. It's like you could see them or you know that they're right there. Because they literally are right there. And so I find with this, you're gonna feel the energy of everything, okay? If you want to do Soul Star, you're gonna feel your soul more. You're gonna see different aspects of your soul. You're gonna even probably, if you want to, get past life memories. If you're ready, you're gonna be getting insight into who you are as a soul, your history, your powers. Stellar Gateway, you get access to all the whole galaxy and you feel like you're in a movie. You're just like, yo, like you see everything, right? I can see giants when I go outside. That's crazy cool. Can you tell me, I guess, confirm if I'm getting better with my travels at night? You are. And let me tell you this, Rainwater, you may feel like they are almost, it feels like they're cloudy sometimes. Like you don't have so much control. You're right on track. You're gaining more control of your travels, but a lot of times then it doesn't feel like you're in control and it feels like you're kind of be pulled over the place sometimes. That's how it starts. And that's where you're supposed to be at right now. So you're right on track. Yeah. Am I too angry? Birdman, you've been working on your anger though. You've been doing good noticing your anger. That's a start. You've been working on your anger, not just your anger and your frustration, but the way that you've been thinking about things, what's been triggering the anger. That's where your guides are trying to point your head at. If you've been noticing, they've been like pulling your head toward the core of something, like the core of what is making you angry. It's always the way you see things. That is what your guides are trying to make you focus on right now, is the core of your anger. That is going to help you. Let me tell you this. You're going to see there's so much happening. There's so much things that are always going to bug you, but you can't let those dictate your energy. You cannot. You know what things annoy me? It annoys me that, let me put it like this. It annoys me that I can't, for example, tell certain or show people who I am or expose who I am. So for example, I was just on an assignment earlier and I went to these guys' house and the one guy I was cornrowing his hair, he wanted me to cornrow his hair. And the other guy, we were just talking about life and stuff like that. And on this mission, I knew we were just supposed to talk. And then they started talking about consciousness. And they were like, yeah, I know there's a God and stuff like that. And you know, when those things come around, I'm like, oh, I want to show them. I want to show them how connected they are. I want to show them what I could do and show them what they could do. But my guides are like, no, not this one. And when I don't listen, then there's always things go weird. It's either like they block the energy. So then it's like I feel disconnected and then it feels like I'm trying to pull energy because they're saying no, Cash, like you're not supposed to. Or it's either that or like I give them stuff and it's correct, but it doesn't click. It's like they're like, whoa, like I don't know how you knew that. But then they're like, but anyways, and they keep going about their life. And I'm like, right, like how did it not click that I just pulled something from ether for you? You know what I'm saying? Those things used to annoy me. They don't annoy me anymore, but I had to get to the core of that because I would get angry that I'm like, I just want to show them the universe. You're not supposed to. You're literally supposed to play a part in their life in a certain way. So that's an example. That's me being transparent about what annoys me and what I've been working on. Yes, I've noticed that too, how they can't comprehend it right. And so that's why I'm like, don't try. Don't try anymore. I only do so when the guides are like, yes, this person needs, like, they need insight from the ether. They need to know that you're, like, what you could do, right? So then I give them insight. But others are like, don't. You're not supposed to. They're not ready. That's just an example of transparency. Okay. So let's start with a little meditation. We're going to get into the Stellar Gateway and Soul Star meditation. Okay. We'll do a good 2-3 minutes of it, right? Just so you guys can feel it. And then you guys will be able to do it on your own, all right? I'm going to clear the energy. And you know what? It was actually Broly who inspired me to start clearing energy before we do stuff. So let me do that real quick. All right, now I want you guys to close your eyes. I want you to feel the universe. I want you to feel a white beam of light coming into your crown chakra and going down into the earth. Every time you breathe, you're breathing in white light and you're breathing out anything that's not serving you anymore. All the heavy energy from anything, you feel like going out your root chakra and into the planet for a transmute. And I want you to feel that. Feel the white light going all the way to your arms, all the way through your legs. Just breathe. Breathe out any thoughts that are in the back. I can feel y'all with those thoughts. Push, just let those out. Let those go. If you don't want to forget something, write it down on a piece of paper and put it aside, okay? Just breathe now. And now you're going to feel, I want you to feel your greater soul, the whole part of your soul above your head. Feel like you are right there. The greater version of you is right here. Feels like a giant white light above your head. If you want to connect to the soul star, do this and allow that white beam to be connected to that soul star. If you want to go to the stellar gateway, see the galaxy above your head. Just like in the picture, see the galaxy above your head and the white beam is connected to the galactic center and you're allowing that energy to fill you. Whatever one you want to connect to, whether it's a soul star, Stellar Gateway, or both. Just take a minute to feel those energies. Take 30 seconds right now just to feel it. Now, don't forget about the earth below your feet, the being that we came here to help. I want you to feel her under your feet, even if it's just a wood floor in your house. Feel her. Feel the stability that she's giving you. Now, I want you to envision that white beam of light that's connected to the Stellar Gateway or your soul star, or both. I want you to envision the other end of that white beam going into the center of the earth. Now I want you to feel both. I want you to feel the earth and the galaxy and your soul. Feel the galaxy, your soul, and the earth. Just take a 20 seconds to just analyze how it feels. Remember, don't think too much, okay? Just analyze how you feel when you do this. If you want to get scientific, your electromagnetic frequency is connecting to the electromagnetic frequency of the planet and literally the galaxy, okay? So if you're asking, am I doing it right? Just feel the connection. Pull that energy in through your thoughts. Sometimes all you do is see the galaxy in your mind. You see the earth as well. Now this is optional. If you want to do this, you can. Feel the energy of the earth when you're breathing in. Feel the galaxy and the earth's energy coming in. It's like it's coming in to your solar plexus. And when you breathe out, the whole energy is going out. Now if this is too overwhelming, you're like, well, too much energy, just do one. Just do Earth or the galaxy or your soul star, okay? Some of you feel buzzing. That's good. The buzzing is good. The guides are chatting. I'm gonna say something else. Now, you may notice when you're doing this, it's like your mind's really clear for some reason. Like, you're like, why is it so clean? Like, it feels so serene. That is exactly what this meditation is helping you do. You could do this anytime you like. The way I feel right now is as if I just finished some kundalini yoga. Little secret I'm gonna tell you is I just had y'all do some kundalini energy right there. You can feel it going up and down. Now notice right now, you may still be in the meditation, notice the energy in your spine. Notice how you can feel it literally going up and down your spine. From now on, you're gonna see your spine as sacred, very sacred. Now here's a optional as well. You may notice you want to stretch your back. Like, I go like this. Literally go like this. Oh, I can feel it cracking. I don't know if y'all heard that, but that's releasing the energy. And before I go to bed, my chiropractor taught me this one stretch to do. I wish I could show y'all. But like, I literally put my leg across my other leg and I push my back like this. When you stretch, you'll feel the energy moving up and down again. Now, if you close your eyes, you'll notice you could feel the energy moving up and down. That's kundalini. That's electromagnetic energy moving up and down. And it's there whether you know it or not. But now you've activated and you've allowed the energy to flow. Now, some of you can feel some areas of energy where you're like, how come right here feels stuck? Like, it, even when you're feeling it going up and down or seeing it in your mind's eye, you feel like it's stuck somewhere. You may want to look at that chakra and see what is up, okay? And you just analyze that chakra for a minute and see what's going on. Envision that energy flowing again. Remember the white light? You could give that old energy to the earth to transmute and allow the white light to allow it to move, okay? And if you want, envision the energy moving up and down. Oh, just burp confirmation. Energy from the earth, energy from the galaxy. My heartbeat got really loud and strong, and I was like wiggling sideways left and right like a snake almost. You go. Someone said my ears started ringing. Bomb. Okay, see what starts happening. All this stuff starts happening when you allow the energy to move. And now notice how just clean you feel. It just feels clean because you let all the old energy out. You may notice some other areas where there's energy stuck. Just move it. That's all you gotta do is move it. Okay, now I have to bring this up. If you're still in the meditation or maybe you want to jump back in again, notice any areas where energy is stuck. Sometimes in your mind, it's just thoughts. Things are stuck. Things that are forced upon you. Especially thoughts forced upon you. Remember, things aren't divine if it's forced on you. If you have to do this, if you gotta go there and do this, if you have to do this or this is gonna happen, that's not divine. That's not divine. Divine is flow, right? So do what always feels right to you. I could tell you, oh, you have to do this meditation or else you're not gonna be connected. That's not divine. What's divine is saying, if you want to feel connected, do this meditation. This is a meditation that could help you. Or you could try a different meditation that feels right for you. Again, I have to say this because there's a lot of attacks going on right now, as you guys know. Whether it's just, a lot of it is mental attacks of low vibrational beings. If you notice people are prideful or you feel insecure or you feel like you're, especially your OCD kicking in, like you have to do this or else this is going to happen. These are attacks. These are energies you're allowing in. Energy, divine is flow. Okay. So sometimes beings will use your OCD. Oh, you have to wash your hands 3 times or else you're going to have a bad day. That's not divine. Oh, you have to have a crystal and you have to have it beside your bed. That's not divine. An angel would say, oh, we recommend you put this crystal beside your bed. It's going to help you with this. That's divine because free will is big. I know that's what I wanted to talk about because everybody's been getting attacked lately. Okay. And we're going to have some people come on. We're going to do some divinations in a minute. All right. But first I just want to make sure you guys feel the energy clearing. Okay. Now I could feel your guys' thoughts. All right. Right now. And I want you to just, because I know now you guys are thinking, oh, shoot, where am I being attacked? Well, is this an attack? Is that How about you just look at it? Make it simple for yourself. Look at where energy is getting stuck or where it's dense. Whether it's an attack or not, it don't matter. You know that there's dense energies that are preventing you from getting into the energy you want. This is their time to go into your energy, how you feel. How should we clear the dense energy? You could do this meditation, or you could do where you do a mind travel. If you guys want to mind travel, you just literally just sit down and allow your mind to do whatever, and you're just allowing your mind to show you stuff. And you may notice certain fears come up. If a fear comes up, you're like, okay, obviously I haven't dealt with this, or an anxiety, obviously I gotta deal with this. You're feeling those denser energies and you can handle them just in your mind right there. You don't need nobody but you. I mean, we all need help once in a while, but just sit down with your mind. Literally just sit down like this. I actually like doing this when I'm like bored in public and like I have to wait for my parents and I don't want to be on my phone. I just sit down in my mind and it's fun to me. I like, my mind is like a movie and I can travel and go into different areas. It's like an Akashic. I get to go and see different areas of my mind. See what things are in my, I call it my glove box or like my mailbox. See what energy was being given to me or what energy I haven't handled yet that's just sitting there. Those are, you're going to notice blockages and it feels like you haven't been in your email for like, there's like 100 emails in there and your mind's tense because there's so much things you're thinking about. When you do that meditation, you could finally go through your email and see what needs to get rid of. Oh, that thought, oh, I'm anxious of the test tomorrow. There's nothing I could do about that. I studied. Okay, bye. Oh, well, this thing, I'm nervous because I'm going on a date tomorrow. Well, I'm excited to just show them who I am. And I'm always going to be nervous because I don't know what to expect. But I accept that and I accept that I can't change what's happening. And I'm excited for this. I'm excited for what's going to come. Push that away. All right, next. Literally, the mailbox. This is going to help you to clean all this energy up, bro. The white beam connected to the soul star, the stellar gateway, and rooting that energy in you and breathing out all the dense energy into the earth. And then connecting with the earth after to kind of breathe through the planet. Sometimes I like breathing through the planet. It feels like the earth is expanding and closing like it's breathing. And I'm breathing. It's like it's my lungs. The earth is my lungs. Oh, shit. My bad, bro. I had to cuss with there because that energy is so good. See what Sky Woman just sent here? You'll feel that. Feel the energy moving up and through. Yes. Okay. Now, if you guys want, we could do another meditation at the end. Right now, I want to get a few of you on. We could chat for a little bit, all right? And then we could answer any questions and things like that. First, I'm going to get Mary on. Hey, Mary. How you doing, sis? Oh, you're still muted.
Oh, my bad.
You're all good.
I'm doing good. Okay. Well, I was going to ask you, because it's funny that you're talking about meditation of how block energies right now. And I started this morning because I was talking to my friend because he's having surgery in his back. The image I got was like he needs to like stretch. Like, you know, I don't know if you've seen those machines, like you lay down and it kind of like pulls your spine. Mm-hmm. But anyways, that's funny how you guys are talking about stretching. But anyways, my thing was, like you were saying, I'm also being attacked really bad as well. I'm also going through my shadow, another shadow going through some stuff as well. To the point, like one of my friends kind of like no longer talks to me, or this decided no longer talks to me. So, and then I'm having like attacks, really dense attacks right now. So I guess the meditation, what you just said, it makes sense to think about what's going on. And also want to remind everyone that we are still powerful no matter what happens, or they throw at us, that we keep our light on no matter what. And, yes, you know, ma'am. bring our higher vibration up as well, and let them know that we are more powerful than them. They have their last fights and they're still at it, but we are more powerful than we, some people think, but we are powerful. So see, my ear is popping.
Yeah, you got it, bro. You right on.
Yeah. Normally when my ear pops, it means that there's some type of energy. I don't know. To me, I look at it more like bad energy. So I'm thinking maybe I'm being attacked right now as I'm trying to tell you what's going on. Maybe I'm being attacked, but it's some type of an energy because my ear just pops as I'm talking to you guys.
Let me ask you, what's going on with the house? Are you moving or is there movement? Tell me what's going on with the house.
Yes, I'm trying to purchase my first house. I'm trying to be a homeowner. Mm-hmm. I've been having this for like past 5-6 years and I haven't qualified, but I already feel it. I'm going to get it this year.
It's coming. It's real close. It's like it's right there and you could feel it.
Yeah. I feel it. Yes. Yeah, I was able to find like programs out there. So thanks to my ancestors, they're going to help me with $67,000 to buy a house. I just need to fix my credit and I just need like a down payment, which I'm almost there. I'm almost there. But I feel it. I feel that I'm going to get it this year.
What's happening with the car too? Your guys talk about a red car. It almost looks like a sports car, red sports car. What's going on with anything, come up with a car yet or something like that?
No, not yet.
Okay. So is this someone's car that's like the red sports car?
Yeah, I don't know that yet. I haven't come across yet. Maybe in the future. I have a car. I mean, I have an SUV, which is a sport. It's a sport, but not a car though.
Okay.
But
is that really a red car?
No, it's white.
Okay. I'm curious where this red car is going to pull, because they showed me that red sports car and I like it. I like it.
Ooh.
I really like this phase now. I know you've noticed, it almost feels like you're in a caterpillar phase. So it's like you're growing inside and then you're about to burst out. Literally the phase you're in right now, your guys call it caterpillar phase. So you feel like it's just, there's so much more you want to put out and show it. It feels like you're like ready. Like you're ready to really just like go. But there's still like a little more. You're like, just wait a second. Like, there's a little more. We got to do a little more. I want to do before we go out. Yeah, you're getting ready to literally burst out. And I'm excited for this.
Yes. And that's what I told. I think her name, Flame, her name. I forgot her name. The one that she reads angels. She did say something that that's more like, I do that. Like, I want to, like, when it comes to my abilities, like, I always want to surpass some things, you know? Like, I just want to go to from point A to point Z, right? I'm always, I'm an Aries, so I don't have patience. But I always want to jump hoops instead of, you know, going through the process. I'm always like that. But my guides, it's funny because I get all my divination to dreams. So for example, like they keep telling me like events are happening. Like for example, they told me in my dream that there was going to be a tornado, and then they showed me buildings, and that was, I wrote it down. It was May 14th. And then on May 16th, the tornado that happened in Houston. And I was like, damn. Right. So I get my divinations to dreams. That's how I get in contact with them. Mm-hmm. But the cool part is that I had a dream the other day that they were telling me I'm going to be able to read. Like, for example, let's say somebody comes to my house and then they leave. And if they're talking about me or a situation that I'm going to be able to hear the conversation. And I was like, woo. But the funny part is that, like, if they're talking about me, I won't hear that conversation. They won't allow me to hear that. But if they're talking to a point of significant of whatever a topic that I need to understand, that's the kind of part that's going to allow me to hear. So my question was, is that what's happening? Is that coming?
You're right on track with the divinations. Sorry, what was the question? You said you wanted to know what was happening?
Oh, I just want to know if that was going to something happen. Like, if I'm able to, like, listen, like, they're going to show me that I'm going to be listening to the conversation.
Yeah, man. Yeah. You're gonna notice it starts with just, like, you've already been getting it. Like, it's like your mind speaks loud for a second. You're like, whoa. Like, it's like your thought was really loud, but it's almost like you know it didn't come from you, but mm-hmm. it's like it did, because it's like in your own mind voice, but it's like it was put in your mind. That's yeah. literally you hearing these other people's conversations. You're going to start hearing it lots more.
Oh my God. As you're talking, my ear keeps popping.
There you go. They try to get your attention. Like, yes, girl. Yep.
yeah. And it's funny because also, like, if I'm talking to someone who is far away, distant, like really far, and then like I was able to smell the perfume, and I was like, why am I, when I say I smell cologne, I smell men's cologne. And my countertop was like, he was like, I just spray. How come you hear that? I just spray a couple of perfume on the, you know, in my room. And I'm like, I don't know. I just smelled it. And I was like, kind of got myself like, whoa. And it's crazy because you said it too when you were talking the last time about you said it in dreams, right? We're going to be able to smell it, like when we have dreams. But it's crazy. I started to smell things as like if I'm talking to a person. So it's more like I started as empathy. Like I was able to, like, I can see what the kind of feel what the other person is feeling. But now to mm-hmm. the point, like, I can smell them. That's kind of weird.
No, I get that too. You could smell them, and you could even like we said last time, so you could taste them too. And that's gonna sound weird, but like you could taste them and like smell them, and you just know like who they are from that. You get more of their overall being from that ability to be able to like smell and taste them.
Yeah. Normally I get that when I do, like, for example, mediumship, like if the spirit comes, like I have my friend that she passed away, and then the only way I know that it's her is that she'll come and I can smell woman perfume. She used to call me cheap perfume. You're going to smell my cheap perfume. That's what she used to say. So every time I smell like a woman's perfume, I know it's her. And then she'll mess with my electronics here and then. But I know that's her. But I never notice it, like, if I'm, like, having someone, like, and I can smell them from far away. I was like, to me, that was a little bit of a trip. But I guess, yeah.
Was there a time when you tried to, okay, actually, let me put it like this, because you're guys are speaking about your ability to move energy really good. And it's almost like, it's like Reiki. It's like we would say it looks like Tai Chi. You're literally just moving the energy around like this, mm-hmm. and you're like putting out the window. Have you been doing that recently?
I was thinking, because the other day I was sitting down in my room, and I was just thinking about myself here. I noticed my hands get extreme hot. They get really hot, and I don't even know the reasons why, right? So I'm looking at my hands and I'm like, okay, am I going crazy? But I feel like I have fire in my arm. So then I asked my mom, I go, Mom, it feels weird. And she was like, what's going on? I go, my arm, my whole hand is warm. So I place it on my mom's shoulder, and she kind of like freaked out because they were really hot.
Okay, that's literally because that's one of your skills is to move energy. And when you don't, or when it's time to do it, your hands get hot because it's literally like, it's like they're being overcharged with energy. It's like an itch. It's like, do it, girl. Use it, girl. And you're going to notice all of a sudden you want to move energy in the environment or on people. It's like, quote unquote, Reiki. You're going to be really good with that stuff. It's going to start just in the building. You moving energy around and things like that, or using mantras to call energy in. But your hands are huge. Like, you got a strong ability here to move energy with your hands. So this is just your confirmation to start using that ability you got and to do that. Yeah.
Yeah, because I even when I feel anxious for some reason, I feel like a lot of anxious. I've seen myself sometimes when I touch like a cart, you know, like the from the food carts, the metal part, and like flashes come from my hand. Like, you can see like literally like a spike of fire comes out.
Ooh. Cool.
And I was like, ooh, and I told myself, ow, because it hurt, right? And my son was like, I just saw that. You just you just touch something and you created fire. I go, yeah, it hurts too.
Now, your guides are bringing up fruits. Okay. Now, it is time for you to, actually, let me ask you first, has there been any inklings or anything come up with eating more fruits or change of diet specifically with fruits?
Actually, I am, due to Dr. Dawn, because she was talking about how your blood type and what certain foods you should be eating. So yeah, I'm looking into that.
Okay, right on track, yeah. Right on track, because you're supposed to be changing up your diet a little bit. Now, you're going to still be eating all the foods you did before, but you're going to notice your body's like literally turns away other things that it's like a burger. You're like, I don't want a burger. I'd rather just have like a salad and some quinoa and then maybe a mango on the side. Like that feels way better to your body. Like just the thought of it, your just body gets excited. Yeah, you're going through a shift in body as well. So even if you try to ignore it, you're like, you know what? I'm gonna go and still get Wendy's. It's like you go get the Wendy's and then you get it twice, and even though you're like, your body's like, no, and then you're gonna notice it's literally like rejecting it. So you're going through that bodily shift as well.
Yeah, I used to buy a burger before and then I don't eat it anymore. Like I'll eat half of it and I'm like, ugh, okay, I can't. And then I'm looking to, but I think I used to eat a full, I can eat it all, but now I can't. It's just like half. And then I'm like, I'm done.
There you go. So it's already happening right now. It's turning. And they specifically brought up burgers too. And they wanted me to use that example. And I see why now.
Yeah.
So you right on track for sure.
Yeah. I'm noticing the physical, like my physical is changing too. Like, I don't know if it has to do with mirrors. I'm not sure, but like or I don't know what's going on in my bathroom, because the mirrors in my bathroom, I look different than any other mirror.
Yeah, I'm not getting anything about that, but that's interesting. So you said only that specific mirror, it's like things look different.
Yeah, even it feels more, it feel like my mirrors on the restroom, they look clear. My face looks different. And then when I look at the like a normal mirror from any mirror, like for example, I have a mirror here that I have in my room. I look like weird. Like, okay, this one looks more like me. But the one in the bathroom, it doesn't look like me. It looks like I have filters on.
Mm-hmm. Oh, actually, okay, I know what that is actually. It's a portal. Oh, it's like, okay. You're going to notice too the energy off of it. Is this the one in the bathroom?
Yeah,
that's okay. It's a portal then for sure. Yeah. That's the one that they're saying is a portal.
Okay. Yeah.
So they also talk about purple energy off of it. Have you been seeing purple or blue around
it?
Oh,
yes.
Okay,
yes.
It's for sure certified a portal, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, the purple I've seen, I'm starting to see it in my bedroom now. And
okay,
then
because
one time
there's a mirror by your desk.
Yeah.
And it's like it's almost like when you would do like makeup in or something like that. That one's a portal too.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. The other time I saw the wall, it changed the wall. It's kind of, I don't know how to explain it. It kind of looked like it was like, you know, how it looks when there's like heat in the streets, it looks kind of wavy.
I started
seeing my walls get something start getting wavy.
Ooh, another portal, because they sometimes open and close the one on the wall, right? The wall by the window.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's they open and close. That's one that they open and close. So they literally go like this, open it, come true, and then they close it. So you'll notice sometimes it looks wavy. Literally, that's a portal. You got portals everywhere, man. Damn.
Oh my goodness. Well,
actually, I'm gonna ask you this too. Was there a time where you saw a UFO when you looked outside your window or like outside your house? Okay, so they want you to know that was literally the family. That was literally them like giving you a wink and then they bounced. You know, it was like quick and then they left. Literally, they just wanted to say, we're right here and we just want you to know that, and then we out. That's literally all they want.
They did this thing. It was me and my friend. We were outside and we were looking at the stars. And for some reason, every time I look at the stars, I get kind of dizzy because I feel like I kind of zoom in a sense. Because you know how my vision gets like, I can see far away. So I kind of zoom in and I go into the stars. And what freaked me out is kind of, I saw a light. Kind of looked like a mirror, right? Like a mirror, but like a shooting star, but not really, because normally a shooting star goes and you can see it like disappearing. This was more like a laser. Like they shoot a laser from one star to another star. And I was like, oh, I just saw a laser, you know? or and then we told, do it again, and then they did it again like three more times.
That's so amazing.
Me and my friends were over here yelling like, oh my god, this is awesome, you know, like. And then I got to see they show us how they we saw a shift shifter. So we saw like a plane coming forward, bright light, really big round light. And then my friend was like, is it coming over here? I go, if it's coming, I don't know. Should I sit or should I run? Like, I don't know what to do. Like, I don't know what to do, right? And then it looked like it was coming towards. And then like a blink, it became an airplane. And I'm like, wow. So yeah, they did like a shift shifter too. So they're showing us. The whole night, they were just showing off.
You good, man. You're set. So, no, they right there. And they've been coming in and out of the house, too, in a good way. They've been really helping you well, especially energetically. Just now, they're talking about, they keep talking about the new house, though. They talk about a shift into the new house. So, they're talking about that when that's to come. But they're talking about work in general, work or business, something like that. They're speaking about whatever work you're doing. They're speaking about being there for when you get back and you're like, and you do that as soon as you get home. And it's like, it's almost like they're massaging your back. Like they're like, okay, welcome home. You good. They literally are taking care of you on all these different levels and those random thoughts that you just get. And you're like, it's like an epiphany. You're like, oh, I just know what to do. That's literally them giving you information and throwing it in your head like telepathy, and then you're like, oh
yeah,
I don't know what to do.
For example, like the problem with my house, I didn't know how am I gonna get like more money. So I went to sleep because for some reason my eyes were like, it felt like I had sand in my eyes, and I was like, okay, they want me to go back to sleep, okay, I'm gonna go back to sleep. So I went back to sleep, and my god, it was incredible. They told me in my dream what I need to actually need to take in order to get that money. And then I wake up and I'm like, oh, I got the idea now. They told me.
There you go. That's exactly what we're talking about. We're talking about business and helping out with the business. Yep. Right on.
Mm-hmm. I just wanted to let you guys. Well, the reason why I was here is also because I was, like you said, we're being attacked. And it's crazy how they attack us in different ways. It can be physical. It can be emotional. It can be even in your state of dreaming, your thoughts. So just want to tell you guys, just hang in there, because just make sure to lift our frequency up. Make sure that we're drinking a lot of water, because one of the things they told me is drink a lot of water to, you know, clean our body, move all that energy out.
Yes. Thank you so much for that message. And thank you for sharing everything with us. And I just want to say you're doing great. And whenever you get this new house, you better send us some pictures. I want to see what it looks like.
I will. Thank you guys. Bye.
All right. Love you so much. Bye. Okay, I know she's got some cool guides, eh? Like, damn. Yeah. Let's see who is next. Hey. Oh, we got Budman. Yes, sir. Budman. What's up?
Hey, what's up?
Nice to see you, man. How's everything been going?
Crazy. Absolutely crazy. Had that car accident like 3 days ago.
Ooh. How's everything been after that?
Car, I don't know. I feel like the car is time to go. And also, I was driving reckless before that. Confirmation, I should not be doing that unless necessary. But yeah, lessons. I'm glad nothing happened. I defensively drove, swerved out of the way, but felt like a hit. I don't know if it was or wasn't, but it was weird how it went down. Someone slowed to a stop sign, and when my car was in front of theirs, then they hit the gas. And I was like,
that's crazy, man. I want to actually ask you, since you've had this happen, and I know that's been aggravating and got a lot of anger swirling around, who's the guy that you've been hanging out with? Or maybe he was in the car too?
You said a guy I've been hanging out with in the car?
Yeah, it may not be in the car, but there's a guy. I don't know if this has been like recently or if this is future, but there's like,
it's gotta be Genie.
Oh, it's Genie?
He's the only person I hung out with.
Okay.
Hang out with a lot of people.
Who's the white guy your guides were showing me? Almost looks like a guy that would go to the bar, drives around, and he's kind of looks a little rougher. He's got some hair. Kind of looks like a country guy.
Interesting.
Do you know who that guy is?
Do you know his color of his hair?
I think it's brown. It's brown.
Brown? I don't know. I don't know who you're talking about. I had a thought in my head just now, but he has like reddish hair. Brother, yeah. Okay. He's darker skin though. He's not white.
Okay. Okay, so they mentioned the brother. I'm curious, maybe this will come up later. We'll see what's up. We'll put that aside for a minute.
A brother? I got two families. I'm a half. I have two. Yeah.
Okay, because when I asked, they said brother.
Might be on the other side of the family because they're white. Huh.
Okay. Okay, they just brought him up because he's coming around and he's going to be like in... Is there a gathering coming up, a family gathering that you know of anytime soon?
Not like that. I have my sister from the darker side of the family and my brother-in-law and their children coming to visit the house, but no one white.
Because there's going to be a time when they come around and this other side of the family, because they've been in the shadows, you haven't been like around them, and you're going to get to know them soon. I don't know when, but they keep saying gathering, where there's going to be, it's almost like a barbecue, and then you meet them, and it's kind of like a whoa, like they're here. And it's like you're nervous, of course. You've been avoiding them. There's been avoidance
for a while. It's funny because you've been saying shadow. I feel like I could see my dad like secretly planning something like this. I don't know. But yeah, hey, whatever happens.
Yeah, okay. Definitely let's see, because you guys are talking about this family and them coming around. And interesting. What have you been researching a lot recently? You've been diving into a lot of information. Tell us about it.
Everything. Jeannie confirmed I'm Octorian. I'm very logical. And lately I watched a debate on the Patrick Bet David podcast.
Ooh.
I love that guy. That dude's a genius. But Dave Smith versus Chris Cuomo, blatantly talking about the corruption in the USA. And Chris Cuomo, I'm sitting there and I'm like, either he's a reptilian narc or this dude is delusional and drank too much Kool-Aid. Because this man is sitting there 3 hours. I'm halfway through. Invigorating. Oh my gosh.
Ooh, actually said, if you want, DM me that link. I'm down to watch that later. So I want to ask you, what's been going on with UFOs lately? Research into UFOs or UFO phenomena? Tell me about that.
Today I saw a plane. It looked a little weird.
Okay. So, okay, let me tell you what's up, because there's, you guys call it the UFO era, the UFO phase. When you're diving into UFOs and craft and you're trying to understand them a little more, just know that's...
I was talking to Jeannie recently about, man, back in the day, the U.S. government, Bob Lazar, came out and talking about the crafts that they discovered in, I want to say it was Roswell, New Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
So theoretically, the idea is that you want a very specific metal, very specific material. I don't want to say metal. Very specific material. You want to create a very specific environment around it and then etch specific symbols inside of it. And you can have basically one of those spacecrafts that they go from the mothership, like those really good ones, the ones that can levitate, zip-zap, go wherever they want, basically like can go as fast as they want, like those things. Yeah. I'm really interested.
Everything you said, look how deep you already know about it. This is exactly what your guys are talking about.
Years ago.
All of this,
I'd be studying years ago? All the time.
Ooh, this is going to come in hot even more. Like all this information you got is coming up again now, and it's like you're putting it to use again. Yes, there's something going on where you're going to be using this information, putting it out to, using it in some way. This is going to be interesting. Yeah. But any questions or anything? I'm not getting anything directly.
I'm kind of just blank on the head right now since you just asked. Not really. I mean, okay, I have something I'm thinking about right now. My fiance and I are in an interesting point. We've been together for 6 years. We're both starseeds for sure. She's excellent. Like, she's one of the best people I've ever met. But the only issue is she's really into, like, the human aspects. And she's super convinced, like, school is telling her the complete truth and all these other things. And I try and bring up evidence. I try and talk to her in a very logical way. And she will get very upset with me real quick. And usually we'll start arguing because she doesn't want to hear any conspiracy theory type stuff from me. I try and keep it as like, let's have a conversation as I can. But it's difficult to try to navigate those types of dynamics with her. Mm. Very, very interesting type stuff.
Okay. She's going to be a little bit slower when it comes to the conscious aspect of it, and you've already kind of like accepted that, and I want you just to accept it fully, because you're going to be a little more ahead than she is in this area. And has she been talking about traveling, or has it been you talking about traveling or moving
around?
She
wants to go camping.
Okay. You guys are going to be traveling, especially in the future. Like, you guys are going to be going to, okay, can I say that? Okay. You guys are going to be going to like Spain. Spain area. Did you know about that already?
Nah, I'm getting a little teed because, like, who? So, like, I tried showing her a channel from Bashar, and it was talking about traveling with no money, and she was impatient, didn't want to watch it. And I'm sitting there, and I'm trying to talk to her about raising her frequency and faith in that the universe will take care of her. She's super worried about everything, and I'm like, we gotta go. We gotta just jump right into it. So I'm trying to help her with that, where we'll, like, we're going on camping a lot more. So we gathered the equipment, spent like $500, and then we took a vacation. We should have stayed, now that I think about it, and tried to, like, adventure better. But we went to Virginia and then Shenandoah National Park. Great place. If anyone is in the USA and you like any type of outdoor, that national park is amazing because it has 100 miles of road on a mountain. And they have multiple campsites where you can either lodge at a campsite they already have, camp with your own camping equipment, RV, camp, tent, anything. Like, great place. We stayed there one night, and then it was supposed to rain for the next 2 days. So we then came home. Now we're going to go. She wants to go to someplace in New Jersey in this month. And then next month, I think, whenever it divinely happens, we're going to go see her grandparents in upstate New York and camp around there.
Okay. This is just a warm up, because it's no coincidence that you were just thinking about, you know, like, we got to go out here. We want to travel without any money like that. Just know you guys are going to be moving around, especially Europe. That seems to be a big place. So just know you're going to be moving in a little bit, but stay comfortable right now.
Friends in Europe.
Here you go. So you see the gateway over there. You're just in like a, you are getting more settled within, not just like yourself in a way that kind of sounds general, but you're settling within yourself, and she's got a lot more she's exploring too. And the traveling is actually going to help her with understanding the conscious stuff. So have some patience with her and keep doing your thing, because you're getting very advanced and you are going to be the way to show her the way, in a sense.
Okay. But yeah, that's something I've been struggling a lot with, is helping people who don't ask. I was taught that humanly from my mom. But yeah, I have so much trouble with that.
You're always going to be someone that loves to help people. But just like we talked about earlier, your guides are going to tell you when to help and when not to. And you already know when to go in, when not to. Or you ask the universe. Start asking the universe, like, okay, like, you just ask the GFL, do I give something here or not? And if you get a yes, you know, to go in, and you know how far. If no, then you're like, all right, pull back. And you're going to be able to trust your intuition when you start getting insight, especially from them. But you're going to have to prove to yourself that you could trust yourself. That's going to be another thing for you. But that's going to be in the next few months. You're diving deeper into intuition and things like that. Right now, you're kind of getting ducks in a row, and you're getting things aligned mentally to get into this stuff.
Interesting. I've been going through a lot of change too, especially since that accident. It was wild. Had a healing day with Jeannie, had a healing day with my fiance, went through a whole bunch of mental change, physical change. Oh my goodness. Like, it's been crazy.
It's time. It is time for the change. So just know, things are going to be, you're going to have these different phases come up. Like, in a few months, it's going to be all about intuition and trusting your extrasensory. Next thing you know, it's like right now, it's all mental. It's all like the mental being calmer, working through your certain thoughts and certain mentalities. It's all very mental based right now. And then soon you're going to shift out of that in the next few months. And then you're going to be all about energy. Trust that. So not much longer where you're going to be in this kind of mental tense energy. That's why I'm saying just focus right now on cleaning up. You're cleaning up your house. That's an analogy for your head. And you just mentally just going through what you don't want there anymore and making peace with certain things. You good. You go. You good. You set. Other than that, I'm not getting anything else. You got everything I was supposed to give.
I guess it's time for the next person.
I appreciate you coming on, bro. And I'm glad you've been working with Jeannie. I know he's been helping out a lot.
I want to meet Broly.
Ooh, Broly, you hear that?
and I said I was going to meet you. And look, my first time hitting that camera on.
There you go. So glad you did, bro. And you already know, see how it's laying up. So it's here. Next thing you know, Broly's about to come around whenever it's divine timing. Yep.
Bro, y'all dragons. Bro, I respect y'all.
And we respect you too, bro. Thanks for being part of the family, for real.
I appreciate that. Of course. I'm here for anyone. and a part of this tribe, like as Ski says, if I'll need some, trust me, I can help you. I
appreciate that. Thank you for being here, bro. And thank you for sharing everything. That's my boy, bro. So glad he came on. And that was, this is always so fun, bro. Getting to see your guys' journeys and getting to see where everyone's at, where they're growing, seeing the vastness of everybody's journey is beautiful. And I adore it. Let's do the next one. Robbie said, we have an astral tea party. Yeah. Astral said, I feel like my journey is still on pause. It is just a little bit more mental work you're doing. Don't forget, we talked about last time, more just the mental work you're doing. The whole thing is about getting your ducks in a row mentally and personally. And then things are going to be turned back on where your focus goes back to consciousness. See your spiritual journey. Your spiritual journey is right now. Everything you're going through right now is part of your spiritual journey. You're working at the core, the foundation, so you can build up. And you're doing great, my man. Yes, so this is your confirmation. You're doing good, man. You're doing real good. I want to train to shadow hunt with everyone. I want to be the best fighter ever. Now, I will say this, that I've been noticing, because everybody in this server, we're a family. Like, we've been calling each other family and all of that, right? But I just want to say that I know a bunch of you want to shadow hunt and you want to go to the astral realm with us because we have an astral team here where we got about 5-6 of us who go to the astral realm and we fight different beings or we travel the galaxy. We do a whole mission thing. But I want to say a lot of you are already in training for this. Now, there's been a few of you who have been training for it. You've been training and then you've come to some like assignments and missions with us and you found it fun, but it was kind of like draining. You're like, whew, that was so fun, but like that was a lot to take out of me. Now this is part of the training too. So if you are the mentality of you want to shadow hunt or you want to go on missions with us, just be aware you're in training. You say that, you're going to start training. You're already starting your training, but it's going to take you a little bit. All right, so enjoy this training, because once it gets to the real leagues, you're going to put all your training into play. So we are going to have more of y'all come on missions with us, okay? And we're going to do a what is it called? A Discord revamp. So like you're going to see us revamp the whole entire server soon, and we're going to have different roles and stuff, but that's going to be in July. So once I come back from, I'm going to Jamaica in a week, and then I'm going to be gone for 2 weeks. I'll peek my head in and stuff and I'll be here, right? But then when I come back, that's where we're going to start the revamp. And I'm working with the crew, working with a bunch of y'all, and we're cleaning up and changing things up. And that's when we're going to start doing shadow hunting classes specifically. Now, we have one coming up that Broly and Andrew are hosting. Shout out to the crew. They are going to be hosting that soon. And we are going to start having weekly or monthly classes for people that want to astrally train. And we astral train together. Like we go to the arena, we go to different areas to train. And we've been having it where some of y'all are assigned certain what do we call them? Apprentices. Like the biggest one I love is like Denny and Ange. And Ange has been taking Denny to go astral traveling a lot. And I love that. So we're going to start doing those where we're going to let the GFL assign it as we do, where it's going to be like the GFL is going to assign you with an apprentice and then you're bringing them to the astral. However that looks, I'm excited for that because this apprenticeship, it's always so divine. Like literally the beings just tell us, yo, you're going on this trip. You're going to help them with this. And I just want you to know that having an apprentice means that you're being told what they're like, how, for example, I'm using Ange as a perfect example because she's being told all the time what is next for Denny, where she's going to bring Denny next, what's going on in his life that's affecting this and that. She's being given all the insights she needs to help him, and that's part of being what y'all call a sensei, being the one to guide another apprentice. And all of us were apprentices at one point, and then you become the one to show the others the way. Yes, and that's why we got to revamp the server, because we need areas where people know who can help them in certain areas and who they can hit up for help in certain things. We need that. Yes. Ooh, and we're going to do a class soon about dark powers, because some of you are exploring your shadow sides. Like, for example, Denny saw his shadow dragon. He's getting to understand that. Genie's a big example of someone who's done an amazing job at meshing their dark side and like their connection with AKA low vibrational beings. and exploring their connection with that and figure out how they want to mesh into their life, things like that. We've realized that just because things are, there's a difference between malevolence and benevolence and light and dark. So you'll notice there's some beings that are darker, but they're not malevolent. They're just like, it's like we talked about vampires. And this is where we grew as a community together, because we realized, because if you guys were in the early days, you remember those days when there were some people, remember there were some witches that came in that were messing around with demons. And my guides were like, but you need this to learn about the light and the dark. And then we saw, and it was caused a whole bunch of drama. We've been through thick and thin in this server, bro. And then some that came in that were connected to dark beings, but were hugely beneficial for us and worked for the light. Like they worked for the GFL certified, but they had connections to reptilians and things like that, dark reptilians. And they had to make boundaries with them and say, like, nah, like, I'm doing my Earth mission, bro. Y'all can't just pull up. Or, oh, I have connections with vampires or with werewolves, right? So this is something that we're going to have a class on, because the bunch of you who are exploring your dark side and want to mesh it to work with the light, but you feel like you're almost being sucked in, like the beings are literally trying to pull you to become malevolent. And that's one thing we face as people that have darker aspects of our souls, or darker history, is the souls that are our family that are part of that darker side try and pull you on their side in the early days. Then when they realize they can't, that's when they stop. And they're like, it's like trying to kill a little lion before they become too strong. And yeah, so I just wanted to mention that. So if you notice you, because even all of us have darker lives. Like I have times where I was a dark Alpha Draco, and then I had dark Alpha Draco family pull up and they were like, hey, you're our family. And I was like, yep, you're my family, but you're my dark family. And I'm not malevolent no more. Right. So I keep those boundaries with them. That's going to happen. Okay. Yes. If you have a black, if you have the black flame, you know what's up. You just need to learn how to use that better. Again, Genie is the best one to help you guys with exploring your darker family, because he was the first one to master this. And so he could help any of you. And there's already a bunch of you who are like his apprentices, where you guys are going to him to learn about the darker side, meshing the darker side. Yes, you good. Okay, so this is what I mean by we're going to revamp the server to have different teachers. It's like, okay, you know you could go to this person for that, this person for that, this person for this, right? We have everything in line. And I want to say big ups to all of you for helping create this family, because look how amazing we are. Look how amazing the server has become and how tight-knit we are. Some of us come every once in a while. Some are here all day, every day. But no matter what, we all see each other, and this is a safe spot. That's how it's always going to be. So shout out. And some of you are connected to my spirit mom, Dawn. Some of you are doing stuff with Dawn. So some of the family, they're part of the family, but they're not mainly working in the server like Dr. Dawn. Yes. So shout out to her. I tried to get it in the server and she was like, nah, I don't do that server stuff. But the people in the server, they can hit me up anytime, which some of y'all did. So big up. Okay, let me get a few more people on. What time is it? Okay, I got a few more minutes. First, actually, are any of you named Dylan Cook? Any of you named Dylan Cook? Someone named Dylan Cook was just texting me. Dylan Cook. Stop, that wasn't supposed to be funny. Anyways, yeah, I know sometimes we do these and then some of you guys add me on Snap. So yeah, don't forget you guys can add me on Snap too. Same as my Instagram. Okay, let's get one of the homies on here. Y'all pick a number between 1 and 5. Okay, let's see. 4, 5. 4 and 5 is the most common. Of course, Andy picks 100. Yeah. You think you're cute, eh? You think you're cute. Okay, 5. That's the person I was going to pick anyways.
Oh, hi. I didn't expect to get picked.
What is good, sis? How's everything been?
Good, good. I'm just like, when y'all started talking about the shadow hunting class, I just got so excited. I'm like, I can't wait to host that with Brawly. Yes, I was like, when you said you were revamping the server, I started to think like, damn, should I wait to hold it till like after you come back, or like should I still hold it before? Like,
it's all good. I'm glad you're doing it at that time. It's actually perfect timing. And then after, we're gonna be doing those frequent ones, because even by then I know me and you have been gonna be traveling a lot more, so we got lots more to give out. Yes, if you want, you could share a little bit about what it's been like so far, shadow hunting and also traveling in a group with all of us.
It's been super cool. Like, it just started happening. Like, I don't know how to explain it. I've been setting the intention and like really trying, like, okay, I want to travel, I want to see what I do, and I know like what my astral self does. I know like his, my thing, I'm a male in the astral, so I love to fight in the astral, and that's just basically his jam, my jam. So I'm like, all right, what am I doing? And I'm like, oh, I'm fighting. That I just feel it in my bones, and I focus on that. And I'm like, okay, I start to see, like, who I'm with, if I'm with anybody, because usually I'm by myself, but I really love when I'm with you guys. And I'm just like, okay, I did a specific mission, or I'm just going out and just, you know, doing, like, getting rid of just any low vibrational stuff that doesn't serve, like, you know, for the greater good. Mm-hmm. And sometimes, like, I'm not able to recall what I do. I mean, it's still a little fuzzy, or I still don't get like a lot of details. Mm-hmm. But I'm still like working hard to get more and more, because I need to like feel like I need to get a better channel on that, because I'm just like, oh, I want all the details, you know.
I want to tell y'all this. So what we can tell you about what we did last night was we were going to go hunt. I know some of you have been watching me on YouTube, so you've seen when we fight bosses. We're fighting another boss in which has been, this is a kind of a long backstory behind it, but been messing around in my town, and some of the kids have been asking for help around the town around this boss. And what happened was I wanted to go and I asked them to come with me. And we actually went to the school. We actually astral projected to the school. And I was surprised because whenever we astral project together, the information spread out between all of us. So I remember fighting this certain being and seeing this and going to the school. And then when we woke up, it's like we wake up at the same time sometimes. Wake up and then they start sending audios to each other. And both Ange and Broly were like, oh yeah, I remember being at the school. And there was like these beings that pulled up at the school and things like that. And so you always get these, you know, it's like we know we were together, but we always get these confirmations after. Yeah. We're like, oh, okay. And then we're like, oh, I didn't remember that part, but I remember this. And then we're like, oh, actually, I remember that part, or that explains this. So the way our astral trips work, it's so cool how it's spread out between all of us. And if you guys want to do the same thing with each other, I would definitely recommend that you guys experiment with each other. But I know it's going to get to the point where we all of us in here start astral projecting together. We're getting there real slow, and I'm excited for that. But just yeah. Know it's going to be fun the way we do it together and the way it's spread out. Yes, it's so cool.
And I know too, like, even though like Deanie's like my like main like trainee, like I know like you mentioned earlier, Cash, like, well, I'll still pop in every now and again to give y'all some training lessons, because I know like I've been feeling I'm going to be doing that too. That's going to be one of my missions in the astral too, like training you guys too. Mm-hmm. So more to come on that, I guess.
It's interesting how we like train each other. Like sometimes we give each other insight in the astral, or like I love having conversations. Like me and Jeannie do this. Me and Broly and Jeannie do this all the time. We're talking about something and then we're like, did we talk about this? I'm like, did we talk about this? And then Jeannie's like, oh yeah, we did in the astral. And I was like, oh. Or Broly's like, did we talk about this? And I was like, oh yeah, because I told you that in the astral. And then she's like, oh, like we always have this, like the way we're connected in the astral, it'll never stop amazing me. And I know all 30 of us that are in here are going to be doing it together when it's time.
Yeah, for sure. So yeah, be on the lookout for those astral travel classes. I'll give you a little bit of spoilers for my class, my first one. I mean, I did write it in a description for my class, but I'm just going to give y'all some like mental well-being steps. I mean, I'm not going to go entirely into it, but for some steps to help you have like a clear mind and, you know, some things you could do and why you need to do this. And, also like maybe some tips, some like, you know, how to maybe like astral project and get started on your training. So okay. More to come on that.
Yes. And I know everybody's excited for your shadow hunting class. And you know, that's actually divine timing, the where where you put it, I was like, yo, if she put it sooner, she wouldn't have as much to say as if she put it where she did now. Exactly. So I'm excited.
Yes, I was talking to Broly about this. I said, you know what? I need to make a class. I need to do this now. It feels like it's time, but I still need that mental, like, prepare, like, mental energy to prepare. So I gave myself a month because I needed to prepare a slideshow. Mm-hmm. And, because I'm working on a slideshow for you guys. So, yep. Cool. So, yeah. And I'm like, what am I doing? What am I saying? I just had ADHD. Oh my God. I'm sorry. So I'm like, all right, I'm going to give myself a challenge. I'm going to give myself a month to finish this PowerPoint. And then I know afterwards I could feel my guides pulling up like, hey, we're going to give you some upgrades along the way. So, baby, yeah.
Yo. I actually want to ask you, because your guides brought up mushrooms real quick. Have they been pushing mushrooms recently?
Yes, they have. They've been doing the same thing with you. Like, when you see a mushroom on somebody, like, that's your sign to take it. So I kind of stole that from you. And I'm like, all right, I hear you guys. I need to start taking more shrooms. But yeah.
Because you're supposed to be doing them soon. They're supposed to be, you're going to have like an epiphany when you do these, man. You're going to be even more sensitive after you take them.
Oh, you got me hyped now.
Definitely let me know how that goes, because I know I'm supposed to take one in a week. So, and whenever they tell me, they're like, okay, in a week. And then when the week comes, and like you said, that I start seeing the mushrooms everywhere, and I'm like, okay, all right, like, I hear you. And then I take them. So I bet you we're going to be taking them around the same time as well.
Ooh, okay. That'll be so cool. Like, I have a couple ready, just saying.
Yo, I can just see them lined up on the counter. I'm dead. That's hilarious. me too, don't worry. But I actually want to ask you about your sensitivity, because that's been strong lately with the energy, feeling everything. Like, you can feel people's, like, the deep part of their soul, man. I want to know how that's going.
Feel like I'm starting to learn it. That's actually funny so you say that, because that's actually a piece of the puzzle I'm looking for. Because I had a guy come to me and be like, here's a gift. You may not understand it now, but here's an upgrade. And it was like a portrayal of like death, like of like a Greek god, I can't pronounce his name, Thanatos, from a game, from this game called Hades. And okay. I used him as an example from a game. And it was this power that he does. And I'm like, what the fuck is this? Like, I don't understand. And I was talking to Broly about it, actually. And they're like, you're not meant to understand it right now. So I said, oh, okay, I'll just, you know, be patient.
And it looks like I spilled the beans just a little bit. Whoops! Yeah.
Well, it's a good hint. Now I'm like, okay, that's what it is.
Yeah, have you been seeing colors?
No, not yet. Oh my God.
I'm spilling. I gotta shut up, bro. Oh my God. I'm chatting too much. Okay. Just know that they're upgrading. You're gonna be like, whoa. And that's gonna, like you said, you're gonna feel people deeper. And that's been who you is. You are a very sensitive person. So now it's gonna be like more awareness in the sensitivity. That's gonna make things even better. So yeah, and if you do need energies with you while you're going through it, of course, we'll always be here with you, because I know how it feels when you're getting sensitive and you kind of just want to escape everything, because you can just feel everything. I feel you.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate it.
I got you, bro. And yes, I know you're going to be doing them astral classes, so for those who want to check those out as they pull up, you know it's good. And after that class that we're having on the shadow hunting one, you guys are going to know things are going to be really sparking up with astral projection and all of us together. So if you start seeing all of us together, like, you guys have a dream where one of us are in there and we're all kind of doing something, you know it's about that time, and we're in that moment right now. So shout out to the whole family and the crew.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Is there anything else you want to say before I go to the next person too?
No, just thank you so much. Oh my God. All right.
Love you so much, Ange.
Love you too. Thank you. Thank you.
That's our girl, bro. That's our girl. Yo, she always gets me excited. My crystal just moved. That's crazy. Just like moved on its own. Oh, yep. And breath work. Yo, y'all want to know a crazy coincidence? So I had a mission with these two Orion kids in my town that I've been mentoring for many years now. And they're just like, y'all, they kind of come in and know the service. And they just see the name Aubrey up in here. That's one of them. And I was on a mission with him. And so it was at McDonald's. I literally went over to McDonald's and I was there with him and his friends. And as I pull up, Aubrey's on the phone and it sounds like Divine Ski. And I pulled up, I was like, Ski? And Aubrey's like, yeah, it's Ski from your server. And Ski's on there, yeah, man. And we're talking about breath work and all that. I was like, whoa, like it's pulling up, right? And then I took the phone and I was like, Ski, I'm on a mission with him right now. You're on a mission with him too? And he's like, yeah, you know, I'm helping with breath work and all that stuff. And I was like, oh, right on track. Because Aubrey's going through a whole breath work thing right now in his Kundalini awakening. Oh, it's amazing. And Ski was sent in to help him. And I was like, yo, he's your assignment too? And I was on the phone because I'm like, he's your assignment too? And he's like, yeah, man, yeah. And I was like, ooh, this is crazy. So I was so hyped. And then I gave the phone back to Aubrey. And me and Ski were like, okay, we know what's up, right? It's just so excited. So I'm seeing how interconnected we're all getting, especially our assignments they're getting, and how we have like a lot of us will get an assignment and it's like two of us. It's like we do it in duos or like in a trio. Oh, so it's so cool. Oh, it's too divine. To the GFL and the universe works in amazing ways. I'll say that. I love it so much. Let's see what's up. Yeah, man.
Yo, what's up? What's up?
How you doing, Z, my home girl? How's everything been?
Oh, I'm great. I'm just on my lunch right now. I got like 5 minutes.
It's all good. We just wanted to check up and see how you doing. Anything new?
Let's see.
How about that crystal? Did you get a new crystal?
I didn't. Or actually, yeah, I did get a new crystal. I have this, a jar, actually, and it's like a bunch of different crystals in it. Some of them I don't know the name. So,
you know what they call that? They call it your magic jar. You notice it just emanates energy, and it's just like, it's just a ball of energy, and it kind of just feels magical. That's your magic jar.
I like that. It's called a ancestor jar. And it has like my zodiac sign on it. I didn't know that. Like when I was checking it out, it had the ram because I'm an Aries. And I was like, ooh, that's so cool. And it has the number 10 on it. And my life path number is 1. So I was like, oh, wow, okay, this is so cool.
Yeah, that is really cool. Have you been traveling a lot, like driving around a lot lately or moving around a lot?
Actually, like just recently, like this weekend, I actually been pretty still. I was like, I normally do go outside and I ground, but not too much traveling. They did tell me to put myself out more. I'm just a little iffy on that.
Oh yeah, because that's gonna be a little bit later. Right now, what I meant by traveling is like, because they show me you going, like you driving from like work to home, and like that's it. Like it's just that. And it's like you work in, maybe you go say hi to this person, whatever, but you're essentially just sticking between these two places. And you're kind of just in like a caterpillar type of mode. But then later you're going to go out and